Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about hardware guys and software guys. Okay, so I have a little confession to make. I don't know very much about hardware. So I've been a software developer for nearly 20 years. God, 20 years. I can't believe I'm even saying that. That's like longer than some of you guys have even been alive. But I've been like a software developer for the last 20 years, right? And whenever somebody asks me a question about something hardware related, I usually fumble about and try to sound like I know what I'm talking about, but I don't, because I've always been more concerned with the software side of things. Like, to give you an example, a couple weeks ago, I was stopped by a neighbor when I was getting into my car, just coming into work in the morning, and one of the neighbors stopped me and said, "Oh yeah, excuse me," right? I'm like, "Yeah?" He goes, "Your name's Eric, right?" I said, "Yeah, we've met like four times before, right? I'm not very memorable." So he goes, yeah, so Eric, you're a computer guy, right?" Okay. By the way, they spoke in an English accent, if you're wondering, right? But I can't do that. "So yeah, Eric, yeah, you're a computer guy, right?" I say, "Yeah." So we're thinking about buying a new computer, and we're wondering if you could recommend, like, what's the best computer to buy? And I said, I'm more of a software guy than a hardware guy. I'm probably not the most qualified person to say that. And he thought, to him, it was just a computer guy. So he just ignored that question and started asking questions like, you know, "Is it better to get 4 gigabytes of memory or 8 gigabytes of memory?" And I'm thinking, 8 gigabytes of memory? You think even with me, you know, 8 is more than 4. So I'm like, I'm just sort of, you know, trying to get out of the conversation because I don't want to show my ignorance in this area, right? And it's really hard. Like, lots of times I'll talk to people and they'll say, you know, "How many cores is this program running under? You know, is it using 8 cores or 4 cores?" And I was like, "Dude, I couldn't tell you." Right? I code to the API and I code to the platform that I'm on. So when I started learning software development, it was like Visual Basic 5 20 years ago, and then Visual Basic 6, and then C Sharp, and then JavaScript, and then all the other platforms there or mobile, so Java and everything like that. So you're always coding on top of a platform. In Java, you're coding on the virtual machine, which by very definition is not the actual machine, right? As opposed to like C developers or C++ developers, those guys are really close to the metal, right? They're thinking about, you know, releasing memory and allocating things here and there, and they're like really low level, very clever. In fact, yeah, I've never been very good at either of those languages. But from time to time, we work with those kind of developers because we do mobile applications that connect with devices for clients, so via Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, and I'll meet the developers of those platforms. So they're the hardware guys, right? So they're writing things and they're thinking in terms of battery usage, and we want to make sure we don't drain the battery too quickly, and we need to send this amount of bytes, and we can just squeeze this little bit of data in there. We can just squeeze this in there. And you know, it's like, you know, they don't want to fizzle out the machine and everything like that, which as software developers who use the platforms that we do, we're very spoiled in that sense, right? We could almost do whatever we want. When I talk to these C guys, like, they say, "Oh, mobile development, that must be very difficult." It's like, I think what you guys do is probably harder. I really do, right? Because we have all these APIs to use, right? And we don't really have to think so much about the hardware. And what we do to a certain extent, like if you're testing a mobile app, right, you should test it with the worst phone you have. You don't test it with your newest phone because you want to go with the lowest common denominator. Same as if you're doing a website or something like that, you want to try to throttle down the bandwidth so you can see how it performs to the lowest, so you reach the widest audience possible. So like if you're doing an Android app, you want to get that old nasty phone that you have from 3 years ago and try that out, or 3-4 years ago, try that out on a lower version of Android. Just make sure it works there, because you know that the faster processor should work a lot better, right? But today I just wanted to create that distinction, because a lot of times I'll tell people that and they're surprised. I say, you know, I don't really know a lot about hardware, right? I'm a software guy. And software guys, like, we can make mistakes and we can just switch it around, right? I was, one of the clients we're dealing with, they were saying how they were surprised at how flexible we were with the code, right? They say, "Can you change this? Is it too late to change this?" Like, "No, we can change it," right? It's not that difficult. We just swapped some things around. They said when they do hardware work, that's expensive. Then they make a mistake in hardware, they have to specify everything exactly up front, because once they start mass producing this stuff, that could get really expensive. They fry things out, you know, they make big mistakes. And as software guys, yeah, it's pretty easy, right? So my question to you guys, are you a software guy or a hardware guy? Or are you the unicorn who's both, right? I wish I could be both. I used to build my own computers back in the day, like buy all the components and everything like that and set everything up. But for the last 10 years or so, I haven't really worried about it, right? I'm more thinking about the APIs. When new platforms come out, when new frameworks come out, that's where I learn. I'm several levels above the machine, but you know, how about you? Are you fascinated by the hardware or the software side of things? So anyway, that is it for today. I will talk to you guys again tomorrow.